हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। डियर फ्रेंड्स, एज यू नो, निष्ठा 3.0 FLN कोर्स इज गोइंग ऑन दीक्षा पोर्टल। सो इन दिस रिगार्ड आई हैव बॉट टू यू मॉड्यूल 3, अंडरस्टैंडिंग लर्नर्स हाउ चिल्ड्रेन लर्न, 40 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ असेसमेंट। वॉच द वीडियो एंड डू योर ट्रेनिंग वेल। इफ यू आर न्यू ऑन माई चैनल, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब इट, शेयर इट टू अदर फ्रेंड्स एंड लाइक इट। नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑन योर स्क्रीन, व्हाट आर द 5 सेंसेस। द राइट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज सी, टेस्ट, टच, स्मेल, हियर। एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट लीड्स टू अ चाइल्ड्स डिफरेंट लर्निंग स्टाइल एंड द रेट ऑफ लर्निंग। द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेज टू ऑब्जर्व द इंफॉर्मेशन, analyze the situation and make decisions. Now the next question, what is the meaning of children learn holistically? The right answer of this question is children observe information from all sources at once. The next question is what kind of interest come under knowing children interest? The right answer is existing interest and potential interests. Now the next one is, where is the positive correlation seen between the current school work and future academic or career goals of children? The right answer of this question is, when children are involved in the work that they enjoy. The next question is, what is meant by interaction with material? Interaction with material means children engage with the range of learning play material. The next one is, the main purpose of the activity interest areas is to give children an opportunity to play and participate in events of their choice. The next one is, children with high levels of creative intelligence are frequently divergent thinkers. And the next question is, what should be the role of teacher in the learning of children? The role of teacher in the learning of children is as facilitator. The right answer is facilitator. Next question is, what should be done when space is less to arrange all activity interest areas in the classroom at a time? The right answer of this question is marked as arrange at least 4 at a time and rotate change every 15 days. The next one is, what are the names of the 3 ways to predict children's needs? The right answer is knowing children's interest, knowing preferences, knowing learning styles. And the next one is, what are the 3 types of interactions in the classroom? The right answer of this question is peer interaction, adult interaction, and material interaction. And the next one is, access to the natural world beyond the classroom and hands-on experiences are the examples of boosting what kind of intelligence? The right answer is analytical intelligence. What is meant by interaction with adults? Interaction with adult means parents and teachers get involved and support children's learning. The next question is, children who ask many questions can be happy, irritating, inquisitive, boring. The right answer is inquisitive. And the next one is, what should children do to become active and autonomous learners? The right answer of this question is be inquisitive, take initiative, be confident, inventive, and reflective. And the next question is, what influences most children's preferences to learning? The right answer is brain wiring, history, gender, and personal experiences. The next one is, maximum learning happens when all senses are involved in learning. This is the right answer. And the next one is, being reflective helps children use their prior experiences in dealing with new situations and experiences. And the next one is, what is the term used for hands-on experiences? The term used for hands-on experiences is eye-hand coordination. And the next one is, what do we mean by knowing learning style? The right answer of this question is personal preferences. And who is the center of the teaching learning process? According to me, children. Children is right answer. How many types of interaction are there in a classroom? There are three types of interaction in a classroom. The right answer is three. And the next one is, what should a teacher do before the start of the learning experiences? Discover children's learning needs. A teacher should discover children's learning needs. And the next one is, a child's previous learning experiences are derived from everyday experiences they encounter. The right answer is everyday experiences they encounter. And the next one is, once teacher have discovered children's learning needs, what should they do? Tailor the learning plan or the instructional process. And the next question is, how many senses do we have? The right answer is 5 senses. We have 5 senses. And the next one is, what are the correct examples of activity interest areas? The right answer is art, discovery, blog, and music. The next one is, what is the full form of NCF 2005? The full form of NCF 2005 is National Curriculum Framework 2005. And what are the 4 modes of information? The 4 modes of information are visual, auditory, kinesthetic, and textual. And the next one is, grouping preferences means preferred interaction like working alone with a partner in a small or large group. This is the right answer. And the next one is, what is the main feature of the activity interest areas to ensure safety of the children? The right answer is here, accessible from all sides of the classroom. And the next one is, being reflective helps children use their prior experiences in dealing with new situations and experiences. And the next question is, what includes pre-existing interest? The right answer is, child has a strong interest or passion for something. And the next one is, when do children learn better? The right answer of this question is, when they engage in hands-on activities. And the next question is, how many ways are there to predict a child's need? The right answer of this question is 3. There are 3 ways. And next one, what are the correct examples of learning through art? The correct examples of learning through art is creating body shapes and identifying patterns of movement, etc. And the next one is, learning is, what is learning? Learning is an active, collaborative, and social process. The next one is, what includes potential interest? The right answer of this question is, interest to which children have not been exposed and might become strong ones once exposed. And the next question is, what is the main feature of the activity interest area to ensure safety of the children? The right answer of this question is, accessible from all sides of the classroom. Okay, dear friends, in this way, I have discussed all 40 questions of module 3. I hope you like my video. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Press bell icon. See you again in the next video. Goodbye.